Brad Fitzpatrick, 2014 Early Career Diamond Award winner.
I know of no other person who's made such contributions to technology in such a young period of time in his life that continue to be true and in use today.
He comes across as the kind of computer scientist who understands what happens inside a computer down to the transistor level.
He's the guy who built all this stuff that like runs the internet. You can look at pretty much any major website today, and they use some or at least one, probably multiple things that Brad has made.
Brad started programming at age 5 and became an entrepreneur by 17 when he founded his first company, Voting Booth. In college, he created LiveJournal, an early social network that popularized blogging. Though LiveJournal started as a way for Brad to keep in touch with family and friends, it grew into an online community of more than 6 million users.
LiveJournal let a lot of people come out of their shell online, people who otherwise I don't think would have, because it had a reputation as being a very supportive community.
It amplified the best things about the internet, which was that you could participate from anywhere. There's a low barrier of entry, and you can share your own experiences. He had his finger on the pulse of what humans wanted out of interaction next.
But what was remarkable about LiveJournal was how he wrote it, right? He wrote this very user interactive web application.
The technology that came out of what it took to run LiveJournal is still in use today.
The technology is called Memcache, and it's used today by all major-scale web services, including Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Wikipedia.
Caching is one of the fundamental problems of computer science. In general, the idea of a cache is to store data that's frequently accessed, but not necessarily all of it. So it's like an intermediary storage pile. What Memcache did specifically, as distinct from other caches, was it allowed multiple computers to share their cache.
You know, Memcache just... It's one of those fundamental tools you use in the serving business. It's turned into literally like the caching layer that everyone uses or provides.
So other technologies that came from LiveJournal that I think of as being significant is the database architecture for social networking sites, where we were concerned with how to serve data when we have an intersection of a lot of people. It's actually become kind of the gold standard for how companies start when they need to scale their data.
Brad eventually sold LiveJournal to Six Apart and served as their chief architect. During this time, Brad created many significant open source projects, including OpenID, a universal online login identity, and GearMan, which enables users to distribute computer tasks across multiple computers. He left Six Apart to join Google.
So the thing about Brad, when he decided he wanted to apply to Google, it was really just a matter of where do we sign.
And I think Brad is in particular good at that. And I think Google gave him leeway to sort of find problems and solve them on his own without necessarily telling him what to do.
Most of his time over the last, I don't know, 5 years has been on Go. Go is a systems language meant for literally the implementation of systems. And it's very, very fast, and it's very, very modern. And it's a remarkable language. So he's a consistent fellow. He codes, he keeps on coding, he keeps on releasing, and that code matters.
Brad is a widely respected leader in the open source community, improving the software development culture and creating open source projects used by millions of websites around the world.
What I think is interesting is that everything he's made, he's given away.
If he looked deep down, he'd say, well, this is how you get technology into people's hands and get them using it. You don't keep them from using it, you give it to them.
I think what distinguishes him is he has a really great intuition for what sort of needs to be done next. He can look at a very large problem and identify the part of it that would be sort of most critical or the best next piece to attack.
He is an example of what I wish every open source developer was, really. What you see in Brad is somebody who releases software constantly, and that software makes things better.
And what will the future hold for Brad?
I know that Brad will be taking an area that we assume is covered today in technology and showing us that we can make it much better.